Hello, good people of the Notion community. This is Matt or Mr. Bio, and I'm here to give you a quick rundown of the agency kit Notion template. Now, I'm really excited about this template, not only because there is a lot that went into it, but we actually use this to run our entire marketing agency on a daily basis. But before we start, I need you to go over to notion.so and make sure that you have Notion downloaded. For those of you who are unfamiliar with the software, Notion is a project management software that is highly customizable and is also free to use. If this is your first time using it, I think that you're really going to enjoy how much flexibility it provides in creating the workflow that you want to be able to use on a daily basis. So since it is required in order to use this template, make sure that you go over to notion.so and download it. It's completely free. All right, now back to the template. So the first thing that you see when you open the template is your dashboard. Now over here on the left, we have links that you can go ahead and replace with your own. So if you have a website, shop, Instagram, Twitter, or TikTok, go ahead and replace those with your own just so that they're easily accessible. But more importantly, right here is really where the heart of this template is. All of the pages that you need in order to manage your agency business can be found in these three columns at the top. Now we're gonna deep dive each of those pages individually in a second, but I wanna go ahead and show you the rest of the dashboard so that you can get a great idea of what you can expect more in depth from all of those pages. So over here on the left side, we have your finance overview. Here you can get a very quick glance at what your expenses, income, as well as your balance is currently. On the right side, we have your OKR overview. OKR stands for objectives and key results. Essentially, that's goals and milestones. So right here, you can set your high-level goals for your company. You can assign them to different individuals. And then when we deep dive into the page a little further in a minute, you'll see that you can actually set individual milestones for every team member. On the left side, you get a quick glance at your agenda overview. And these are essentially items, meetings, whatever you have on your agenda, on your calendar that are coming up within the next week. We also have your projects overview here. And this is probably one of my favorite sections when we dive into it. But this is essentially where you can see your project pipeline and how everything is progressing. On the left side, we also have your pinned notes. So we have an entire notes database built out for you to be able to utilize. These notes can either be assigned to different calls or conversations that you have with clients, or just general notes such as a sales acquisition plan for your business. And then of course, over on the right side, we have your sales outreach overview. And this is also a section that I really like because this is essentially where you're focused on your leads and generating new clients. All right, so let's go ahead and get a little bit more in depth with what all of these pages are. So we're gonna go ahead and start at agenda. Now the agenda section is very straightforward. Essentially on the left side, you have your calendar, which has all of the different events laid out on their actual date. And then on the right side, you have a breakdown that has those same events just in a list format so you can breeze over everything very quickly. Now, a few examples of how you can use this calendar is you can place regular reoccurring meetings such as weekly team sync so that everybody is aware when it's happening, if the time has changed or if it's canceled. You can also place reminders of intro calls that are happening with certain clients, or if there are certain client or project specific events, let's say that there's a photo or video shoot coming up, you can place that on your calendar as well. So it's not only for meetings, it's for events in general that are happening for your company that you want everybody on your team to stay in the loop on. Now, if we go back to our dashboard, we can hop over to the finance section. And I really like this section because this is something that allows you to keep track of basically everything that's happening for your company on the finance side of things. Now at the top here, you have your business account. If you want to make a new account, you very well can. There's actually a template already created for that that you can select. But right here, you can see what your overall expenses, incomes, as well as balance looks like. So for example, if you want to be able to break down all the expenses that you have, whether it be a staff lunch, a membership for your Webflow, Instagram ad spend, maybe even a Lyft ride or a payout for a contractor, any expenses related to your business, you can keep here and you can also categorize. Now, all these expenses can be broken down by month as well as by category if you want to get a more granular view of what these expenses are. And if you need to add a new expense, there's already a template created for you that you can use. Now, moving down the list, you have your income section. Now, here is where you can place anything at all that makes money for the company, okay? Now, the biggest difference between the expenses and the incomes is that the incomes you can actually associate with certain projects. So if there's an invoice that you've sent out for a client for a project that you recently completed, you can go ahead and make sure that you know exactly what that invoice was for. You also have the option to filter by things that are paid, partially paid, or not paid. And you can even break down your income by month or by things that are only related to projects such as invoices for clients. Now, the best part about the finance section is that whenever you add a new line item to the expenses or your income, the number at the top that shows the breakdown of your balance will update automatically for you. All right, let's go ahead back to the dashboard and go over the objectives and key results. As I was saying before, this is essentially a section where you can set goals for your companies as well as smaller milestones. So what I've done here is add the new progress bar property that Notion recently introduced so that you can get a better visual of how close to 100% you are with one of your goals. If you create a new objective, which can be done by just hitting this new button right here, you can also create smaller milestones for it that you can assign to different members of your team. And if you scroll down further, you even get a timeline view. On top of that, you can break it down by the different categories of goals that you have set for yourself. Now let's go ahead and talk about the website section. Now this is essentially a Kanban board section where you can assign tasks to different members of your team in relation to your website. Now again, we run our entire business through this template. And the reason why this section even exists is because we were actually building a new website for ourselves that we could send potential customers to. But we needed some sort of easy way to be able to keep track of all the different things that needed to be done to not only create our website, but maintain it and keep building upon it. So for example, you have everything laid out into different progress categories for you and your team to take a look at. You can assign these tasks to specific individuals, you can set a deadline, you can set what the priority is, and you can even brief everything out. We even create a little section for bugs and maintenance just in case you want to do some optimization to your website or even fix something that might have gone wrong. Now moving on over to the team section, this is where each of your team members is able to kind of have their own profile within your database. And doing so is very easy. There's actually already a template created for this specific section, so you can click on that and go ahead and make a new one. And that way you can go ahead and start making a new profile for your team member. You can upload their photo, have their bio here in case you need it for the website, social media, or whatever else you need it for. And on top of that, you can also label what department they are a part of in your company. Now, speaking of profiles and individuals, that's a perfect segue over to the contacts page. Now, here is where you can store all of your contacts for any client from any company. And if you scroll down, you can also store your contacts for your outsourced talent or your contractors. This makes it very easy to just keep everybody in one spot. So if you need to reach out to a specific individual, either someone that's on the client side or somebody that you're working with on a project, it's very easy to grab their information. All right, now let's go ahead and talk about probably my favorite part of this template. This is your sales CRM. Now we're gonna go ahead and start at the very bottom of the page this time. And the reason for that is because I want you to get an idea of what the flow should be like once you have this template. So let's say that you have a lead for a new client that you could potentially work with. What you want to go ahead and do is click the new button right here so that you can make a new profile for them. Once you do that, you can go ahead and add all of their client information, whether it be their website, some notes on their company, even the category of business that they are. You can even add a main point of contact, which actually automatically updates your contacts database for you. You can also select what part of the sales pipeline process they're in right now. And on top of that, if you've already had a call with them, you can actually connect those calls as well as any projects that you currently have going on with them. So if you're adding a lead for a client that you haven't contacted yet, they will go ahead and appear in this first column. And of course, as you update it, it will automatically update on your board for you. Once you've gone through the negotiations with a client and you've come to an agreement, it's time to actually start the project. Once they're moved over to this closed one section, you can scroll up and you can start. So when you create a new project by hitting the new button, it will automatically open up a template that looks something like this. Here you will add the name of the project. You'll go ahead and add the client that it's associated with. If there are any project assets, you can connect them here, which we will talk about in a second. You can label when it's going to be due, who the main owner is, any notes that are related to that project, as well as the status of it, the value, as well as the final invoice. And if you scroll down, you can add your details, such as the description, as well as the deliverables for your team. You can list out the description of the project, as well as the deliverables, and assign them to specific members of your team. Now that we've covered that, going back to the dashboard, we have the asset library. And this is essentially a library for any media or information that you want to keep on hand for your company. So for example, any brand identity assets that you want to be able to keep on hand at all times, you can keep here. From the logo to the colors used in your branding to any pitch or presentation decks that you have for external or internal uses. And I even create a section where you can keep credentials for different websites that you or your team might need to use. Now going down to the project section, this is where you can store things that are directly correlated with with projects that you have. So for example, if we recently completed a photo shoot with a client like the ones that I was showing you earlier, you can go ahead and store the links for everything right here and make sure that you have something that's shareable with your team. This makes it a little bit easier to find certain media or assets that are related to projects that you either have going on right now or had going on in the past. So for example, if we click into one of these right now, you can see that you can organize everything by category. That will determine which of these three rows it will appear in. You can assign it a client, you can assign it a project if it is media that is related to a project that you recently completed. If you're storing the assets somewhere else like Google Drive or Dropbox, you can go ahead and drop the link right here, or you can attach the files natively in this document. On top of that, you can assign a tag for exactly what type of asset it is so that while you're looking for stuff in the future, it makes it just a little bit easier to track down what you're looking for. Now, scrolling down to the internal assets and resources, this is just an example of things that you can store within this library that might be relevant to, let's say, your social media or your website or any other projects that you have going on with your company. And if you ever want to add anything new to your library, just click the new button and there will be a template that automatically appears for you. And last but not least, let's go ahead and talk about the notes database. As I mentioned before, your notes database is essentially a section where you can store any notes that are related to meetings, calls, projects, or even just general notes that you want to have for your team. So I've gone ahead and created a few different categories for these notes to help you keep everything organized. And I've also added these tabs right here so that you can filter by exactly what category you're looking for. If you have certain notes that you want to be able to easily access for either yourself or your team, I've actually created a pinned notes section over on the right-hand side. This section is also displayed on your dashboard just so that you can access them as quickly as possible if you need them in the future. And if you scroll down, you can sort your notes by time frame. So up here, like I said before, you can sort them by category, and down here you can sort them by month, by week, whatever you need to do. So here's how you use this section. If you're going to be creating a new note, go ahead and click that new button, and you have two options for templates at the bottom. One is a new note, which is just a completely blank page. This is the type of note that you would use for something that is maybe internal, that's not necessarily associated with any specific meeting. But if you want to have something that's in relation to, let's say, a client call or your weekly team meeting, you can go ahead and click new meeting note and it'll have a little templated bullet point list here that you can use for that call. After that, you can go ahead and select what category it belongs to. If it goes with a specific client, you can select that as well. If it's in relation to a specific project that you're working on, this is really nice because this section right here allows you to assign it to a project. If you click on that project, you'll actually be able to see the notes link there as well so that you don't have a million things in a million different places. And that was really one thing that was my goal when making this template, is how connected can I make everything so that I can find the information that I'm looking for with as few clicks as possible. After that, you can also connect this note to an item on your agenda. So since this is a meeting note, I want to be able to select the meeting that it's for. So let's go ahead and say that it is a review call. Let's say that myself and the client are going to go ahead and hop on the phone and talk about the assets that we created for them. This allows you to be able to see on your actual agenda calendar the notes that are associated with that meeting, while also having the note in the database so that you can organize it and really get very granular with how you do it. And then of course, if you want to pin the note, you can go ahead and select that here and it'll appear over on the right side. And that wraps up my overview of the Agency Kit Notion template. Big shout out to everybody who's already picked up this template since it got released. I hope that's helping you run your business very efficiently. I know it's helping us on a daily basis just stay more organized and making sure that we're moving as efficiently and effectively as we can as a team. If you have any questions, let me know. And until next time, I'll see you next time.